The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus departed to the mountain to pray, and he spent the night in prayer to God. When day came, he called his disciples to himself, and from them he chose 12 whom he also named apostles: Simon, whom he named Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, Simon, who was called a Zealot, and Judas, the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. And he came down with them and stood on a stretch of a level ground. A great crowd of his disciples and a large number of the people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the coastal region of Tyre and Sidon came to hear him and to be healed of their diseases. And even those who were tormented by unclean spirits were cured. Everyone in the crowd sought to touch him, because power came forth from him and healed them all. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. We all know that there are three types of people. People who make or who made the choice for their future. People who simply wait for things to happen. And the sad story, there are people who simply wait for things to happen. Again, people who make a choice, they decided about their future, make things happen. People who simply wait for things to happen, and there are those who are not even aware what is happening. And it's good to ask ourselves, who am I among those three? Our life are products of our choices, and if we simply wait for things to happen, we have no right to complain. Pag tayo nag-aantay lamang, ay wala tayong karapatang magreklamo. Kasi ayaw nating kumilos. Ayaw nating kumilos. Even Stephen Covey would say, in his four quadrants, there are important and urgent matters in our lives. There are important and not urgent. There are not important and not urgent. And there are urgent but not important. Mahalaga ba yan? Kailangan ba yan? Mahalaga ba yan? Kailangan ba yan? Pagkaminsan, hindi natin alam kung anong mahalaga. Hindi natin alam kung kailangan ba talaga yan. Pero paano natin malalaman? The Gospel reminds us that even God in His humanity take time to pray before some major decisions. Kung inyo po pinakinggang mabuti, nagsimula ang pagdarasal noong gabi hanggang kinabukasan. Naalala ko, misang ko lang ginawa yan. Alas 8 ng gabi hanggang alas 4 ng madaling araw, nasa Blessed Sacrament ako. Hindi nagtatanong sa Diyos kung anong dapat kong gawin, kundi nagre-reklamo ako sa Diyos. Ano po? Nagre-reklamo ako. January 15 or January 14, 1995, because I asked the Lord, "Lord, I want to kiss the hands of the Holy Father for my birthday." And the late Archbishop Oscar Cruz said, "You will not be able to do it." Ay, nagreklamo ako sa Diyos, magdamag. Magdamag, ano po? Pwede yun. Sa sama ng loob. But God spent time before His Father, before choosing the 12 apostles. He is making a choice not only for Himself, but for the future of the church. For the future of the church. How much of our choices really made not only for ourselves, but for the people we love? Again, people who make things happen. And they made things happen because they pray about it. They not only pray about for their own selves, but for the future of the people they love. Mahalaga yun. Ano po? Mahalaga yun. Sabi nung nag-message kagabi, galit na galit siya kasi nagtratrabaho yung babae sa ibang bansa. At yung kanyang mister na binili niya ng tricycle, ng motor, ayaw pumasada. Ayaw magmotor. Umaasa na lang sa hulog na galing ng kanyang miss. Sabi niya, "Father, nagpapakahirap ako dito sa ibang bansa." Ano po? There are people who simply wait for things to happen. Why? They believe they will be provided. Nagiging tamad tayo. Kahapon, pinag-usapan natin yung mga hindi nagbabayad ng utang. Hindi po ba? Pinautang ka ng maayos, ngayong naniningil na, ikaw pa yung galit na ikaw ay sinisingil. Because we don't want to be responsible. Or, we are not really responsible with our choices. Ano sinasabi sa unang pagbasa? If you will not make a choice for God, then you cannot walk in the ways of God. If you cannot make a choice for God, then you cannot live a life pleasing to God. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, maganda pong pagtunan ng pansin ito. Pag ako po ba'y nagdadasal, ang akin po bang pagdadasal ay, "Lord, bless mo naman itong aking ginagawa." Or, "Lord, tulungan mo naman ako na magawa ko ang bagay kong dapat gawin." Magkaiba po yun. Kung inyong po titingnan ng mabuti, parang parehas lang. Pero magkaiba. Yung isa, gumawa na ako. May ginawa na akong desisyon. Hinihiling ko na lang sa Diyos, i-bless niya yung desisyon ko. Pero yung isa, bago mag-decide, nagdadasal muna para i-bless ni Lord kung anuman yung dapat gawin. How many among us really who prays, really ask the Lord to direct our hearts? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, if we want to make a choice for God, then we must discern. And discernment is always a product of prayer. Discernment is always a product of prayer. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, para mas madali, ano po, mas madali. Halimbawa, kakain ka ng almusal, ano po, meron kang choice. Ang alin, daing na bangus ba o corned beef? Eh, parang gandi po ba? Tapos, kung hindi daing na boss, kung tapa. Ha? Ibig sabihin, umu-order ka, di ba? May choice ka. Ano po? Madali lang yun. Hindi mo naman kailangang magsimba pa para sa, "Lord, ano bang breakfast ko ngayon?" Hindi naman ganun yun. Hindi po ba na? Ha? Hindi naman life-changing yan. Ano po? But there are choices that we really need to pray. "Lord, mag-aasawa ba ako? Kung hindi ako mag-aasawa, ano ba mangyayari sa buhay ko? Magsisilibato ba ako? Magmamadre ba ako? O hindi talaga ako mag-aasawa? There are major choices in our lives. But the sad story, my dear friends, my brothers and sisters, is that many of us don't want to make a choice. I repeat, many of us don't want to make a choice. Hindi dahil wala kang choices, ayaw mong mag-desisyon kasi takot kang magkamali. Yun ang malungkot na kwento. Many of us simply wait for things to happen because we are so afraid to make a choice. We are afraid to make a choice because we are afraid to fail. We are afraid to fail. Ayaw nating magkamali. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, whether you like it or not, heaven is a product of a choice, not simply a consequence. Amen. Para lang mas malinaw, 35 years ago, I discerned for my vocation, and 35 years ago, I heard God said, hindi ka mag-aasawa. Hindi ka mag-aasawa. 35 years ago. But 5 years after that, 30 years ago, umibig ako. Na-inlove ako. So, nakalimutan ko yung usapan namin ng Diyos na hindi ako mag-aasawa. Kaya lang nung malapit na ang kasalan, hindi ako mapalagay. I'm bothered. There was no peace. So, I come again to the Lord in prayer. 1 month yun. Hindi lang magdamag, 1 month. 1 month, I've been asking God to bless my marriage. Mali na yung prayer. Kasi sa simula, di ka mag-aasawa eh. Pero, on the last week, parang sabi ng Diyos, total buo na ang loob mo. Sabi ni Diyos, then make a choice and I will bless it. Make a choice and I will bless it. It's enough for me that you sought what I want. Doon ako na natinag, ano? Ibig sabihin talagang may pinagpipilian. So, I told my fiancé that I will enter the seminary. Ibang kwento na yun. Ano po? I entered the seminary. And this year, I will be celebrating my 25th sacerdotal anniversary. It was a product of choice. Thank you. It was a product of choice 30 years ago. 30 years ago. Was it easy? The answer is no. What I'm trying to say, when you made a choice for God, regardless of the many misgivings, regardless of many trials, you will still be blessed. So even though God had made the choice for Judas, in spite of the betrayal, we are all saved. Again, my brothers and sisters, pray so that you may discern that you will be able to make a choice for God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.